Hey guys, welcome back to another plugin tutorial on the channel today. Today's plugin tutorial is on the Skin Restorer plugin. The Skin Restorer plugin is a pretty cool plugin that allows players to change their skins to any skin that they would like, if they have the permissions to do so, of course. And obviously the main feature of this plugin is that if you have a cracked Minecraft server like my Minecraft server is, it will restore all the premium users' skins instead of making them use the default Steve skin like I'm using right here. Make sure to leave a comment down below if you have any questions, and also if you have any suggestions for future plugin videos, leave them in the comments down below. Let's get right into this video. Okay, as you probably know, a cracked Minecraft server doesn't have any skins, and everyone, even premium users, have to use a Steve skin or an Alex skin inside of Minecraft. As you can see, my skin is a Steve skin, my alt account skin is a Steve skin, and also the cracked skin, or the cracked account, sorry, is a Alex skin. So guys, let's head over to the Spigot page where we can actually go ahead and download this plugin and actually go ahead and restore my skin and restore my alt account skin. Okay guys, so this is the plugin's Spigot page. As you can see, it's got some nice useful informations on it. Here you can see there's some add-ons that you can add, like this one allows you to upload your own PNG skin, like in the skin format that Minecraft has, and it will create its own .skin file that you can put into the skins folder. And then you can add that so that people can use that specific skin on your Minecraft server. There's also a ton of other features, like here we've got the commands and stuff. Here's, you've got the link to the wiki to get more information and all the commands and what they do. To download the plugin, you just want to hit this blue download button and then download the plugin. We've put the skin restorer jar into the plugin folder, and now all you need to do is go to your console, hit restart, and boom, the plugin is installed. Okay, we're now back on my Minecraft server, and as you can see, both my skin and my alt account skin has been restored, so that's really awesome. Both our accounts are premium accounts, and we've been restored to our original skins, and it's still a cracked Minecraft server. So if you're just looking to restore premium skins for the users, that's really all you have to do. Just drop the jar file in and it's all done for you. But this plugin does actually have some pretty cool features and commands for both players and admins. So let's get right into showing you guys how to use these player and admin commands. Okay guys, we're going to start off with player commands. So when we're doing the commands, I'm just going to put the command and the permission on the top of the screen, so that you can see what the command is and what the permission for that is. So the first command that we're going to be going over is the slash skin command. This is just the main command, shows all of the help and stuff. So that's the main command for this plugin, and that's what all the other commands for this plugin are based off. Okay, so say I'm a player on the server and I want to change my skin. So any player can now change their skin just by doing slash skin and then the player name. So let's do slash skin Notch and see what happens. Okay, as you can see, I've actually been changed to Notch's skin, so that's really cool. So let's think about what other skins. Ooh, let's do Little Lizard slash skin Little Lizard. And now we have Little Lizard skin. Oh my god, I used to watch him so much back in the day. It's so crazy. Let's see what their channel is up to nowadays. Little Lizard. Oh, their channel is very much dead. Anyways, back to the tutorial. The next command we're going to be doing is slash skin clear. And what this command will do is it will reset your skin to the default skin. So if you are a premium user and you have your premium skin, it'll reset it to your premium skin. Or if you're a cracked user, it'll reset it to your default Steve skin. So as you can see, slash skin clear, it's reset to my default skin. Okay, there's actually two more ways that players can change their skin. It's really cool how there's so many ways to change your skin. So the next way to change your skin is by typing slash skin and then a URL that will lead to a PNG file format to a skin texture like you would upload to Minecraft.net. So we're going to do slash skin and then a URL. So we're going to put in this URL. This is actually a URL that the developer of the plugin has given to me for this. So let's find out what it's going to be. Okay, it's uploading the skin. What is this? It's like an Alex, but on the body. Okay. Okay. Awesome. And the next way that we can actually change the skin is with slash skins. So slash skins will open up the skin GUI menu. And as you can see, we've got all the previous skins that I've changed to. So when you actually change to a skin, it gets added to this GUI. And I can actually go and change to Little Lizard. I can go change to My Alt Account. I can go, and this is for all the players that are on the server. All of their skins will come up on here. And it's a really easy, quick way. And down here on the bottom, you've got this red thing that says Review Skin. If you actually go ahead and click on that, it'll reset your skin. So that's another way of clearing your skin as well. So that's really awesome. And the last player command that you can actually use is going to be slash skin update. Now, slash skin update is actually for if there's an issue with your skin, you can just update it like that. So you changed your skin through Minecraft.net and you want to get your new skin, you can just hit slash skin update and it'll just reset your skin values like that. So as you can see, it just resets your skin values in case there was any issues or if you changed your skin through Minecraft.net and you don't want to relog. Okay, so that's pretty much all there is for the player commands and features. Let's dive right into the admin commands. Okay, guys, so when it comes to admin commands on the plugin, it's just mainly really back-end stuff. The main command for it is slash SR. So if we type slash SR, you can see it just brings up the help for all of that. And I'm just going to go through the admin commands very briefly and... yeah, oh, actually, let's try to speed run them. Okay, so we've got slash SR status. If we can just type it in really quickly, it will check to make sure that all the Mojang API is working properly and it's for backend developer stuff. Slash SR reload. Pretty self-explanatory. Reloads all the config files. Slash SR props. Player name. So if we do glitch games, it'll show all of the properties and details for the players. There's more info in the console if we go over to the console. Yeah, see, there's more info in the console. Signature, value decoded, etc. Okay, and last but not least, we've got slash SR drop, and then we have to put in a player name, player, then glitch games, and boom. So that means that basically it's cleared all the .skin files in the config for player glitch games. So that's an easy way to clean up and clear the player file with all the .skin files. Okay, so that was my speed run of all of the admin commands. I was pretty terrible with it, but hey, we can try to do more speed runs in future plugin tutorials, and maybe we'll start getting better at the speed runs. But this is basically all there is to know about the plugin when it comes to the in-game side of things. So let's jump into the config. There is also, just to mention, there is message configuration files, but we're not going to go over them. It's pretty self-explanatory. You just change the messages how you want them. Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to go over is the skin without perm feature. So if you set this to true, it actually allows players to change their own skins without having to manually give them the permissions to do so. So yeah, that's pretty cool. So essentially, when you set this to true, they don't have to have any of the permissions. So it can save you some admin work and make it easier to do so. If you set it to false, you'll have to manually put in the permissions. Next down the list, we just have some cooldown settings, nothing really too interesting. You can change the values of that if you want. So next down the list, we have default skins. So this is actually a really kind of cool feature that the plugin has. So if you actually set this to true, it will make it so that any names that you have down here, it will actually randomly select a skin from down here. And when a cracked player that doesn't have a premium skin joins the server, it'll automatically give them one of these. So if you only have one, it'll always be the same skin. If you put multiple, it'll select them randomly. So let's just remove this one. And we're actually just going to make it so that each time a non-premium player joins, they get a notch skin rather than their default Steve skin. Just down the list, we've got the disabled skins. This is like skins that if you enable it, this is skins that players can't change to. So if you enable it, people won't be able to change to the Steve or owner skin set. Then down below, we have the custom GUI option. So if you enable this, when you do slash skins, instead of displaying all of the recent skins that players on your server have changed to, it will display a custom set of skins. And then you can put that custom set of skins here. So that's really cool. So that means that if you've got some server skins, maybe some server mascots that you want to change to, you can put that in that GUI and only let players change to those skins through the GUI. Down in the advanced, there's some stuff like permissions, skin expiry, MySQL database, updaters, no skin login cancelled, old skin help, default prefix, and blah, blah, blah. Then there's also some extra information. So nothing of this I'm going to go over in today's video. It's mainly just developer stuff. And if you're ever having to change this, you most likely know what you're doing. So that's pretty much it for the features on this plugin. And I think it's a really awesome plugin, especially for cracked Minecraft servers. You don't even have to have a cracked Minecraft server because it just allows players to change their skins as well. But it is mainly for cracked Minecraft servers. It allows you to restore those premium skins on a cracked Minecraft server. So we're actually going to go ahead and slash SR reload. And then now we have that notch thing reloaded. We can actually come over here, direct connect with a cracked account. Okay, and just to show off the feature, here we have the notch skin, which is a cracked skin. And it's the notch skin that we have selected inside of the config. So, anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed today's YouTube video. Make sure you smash the like button and subscribe. Once again, comment down below if you have any issues. And we'll see you for another plugin video sometime else. So, yeah, once again, that's all the features of the plugin. It's really awesome. Anyways, we'll see you again soon. Bye.